Hello, good morning students. Welcome back to our lesson that is materials, metals and non-metals. Okay, I think I have taken two lectures for you. First was introductory lesson. In that I had given you an idea what I am going to deal with in this today, in this whole lesson, that is materials and metals and the non-metals. Okay, and in the second session I had given acquisition for you about metals. What is mean by metals, I said you. And in today's session, we are going to talk about what are non-metals. What is mean by non-metals? In metals, I said you, metals are the elements who have tendency to donate their electrons, right? Last time, yesterday's session only, I gave you example of a sodium, okay? Which is the metal. Which metal is the best, which is the precious metal, or which is the noble metal, that also I have talked to you. The best metal, according to the chemistry, who is reactive? The metal which is more reactive is the best metal according to the chemistry, according to the science. But for us, for common people, the metal which is least reactive is the best. For that sake, I gave example of gold and platinum. Gold and platinum are least reactive. They are noble element. They are noble metal because they are least reactive. They don't show their reactivity towards water, towards oxygen, towards acid. Least reactive those are, right? But the metal which is highly reactive are sodium, potassium, cesium, okay? Why they are highly reactive? I said you everything along with the atomic structure and along with the electronic configuration. I explained you actually the tendency of the metal. As the metal tends to always donate electron and to be stable either by duplet or the octet rule, metals always have a positive charge on them, right? Metals will always have a positive charge on them. And this is one important property of the metal, is that metals are always electropositive in nature. Right, so this was all about the metal. And if you will move ahead, I have said you that these metals and non-metals are together considered to be elements, and these elements are all present elements are present where? Into the modern periodic table. Into the modern periodic table, it is properly organized, it is kept, all the elements are into the organized manner. Right, at the right side of the periodic table, I said you most of the metals are present, right? And if you will move from the right to the left, non-metallic characteristics can be seen. So at the left side, most of the non-metals are present at the modern periodic table. And this modern periodic table is bifurcated, means at the borderline of the metal and the non-metal, there is one zigzag line. That zigzag line interprets, or this shows the some elements which are possesses the properties of the metalloids. Metalloids are the elements which possesses the properties of metals also and non-metals also. So that also I have explained you. Now we are going to talk about today about the elements which are situated at the left side of the periodic table. Means what? Non-metals. Okay, then what is mean by non-metal? How non-metals are actually their behavior towards everywhere, and what are those? That we will talk in today's session. So, as I said you, metals have a tendency to lose their electron and to be stable. Everyone into the universe has the right to be stable. Everybody is doing everything for the stability. Now you are into the class 8, right? You are in class 8. You have passed your class 7. Why to become stable? You will pass your class 7, 8, 9, 10, everything you will complete, your primary education, secondary, your all education you will finish and you will get a good job and you will be stable. So here non-metals and metals both wants to be stable, and they can be stable either by donating electron or by accepting electrons also. Right, the elements which are donating their electrons and being stable is called as what? Metals. And they are possesses the charges positive, because the number of protons are more than the number of electrons. Right, and non-metals are always accepting electrons. Right, accepting electrons, and electrons are always possesses the negative charge. Means they are taking more negativity. And because of them, they are having a negative charge on them. How it is shown? I would like to give you one simple example for it. Okay. Suppose if I talk about fluorine. This is the fluorine. And this fluorine is considered to be non-metal. Why it is considered to be non-metal? That I will say. Okay, fluorine has atomic number 9. Atomic number is denoted by Z, right? And its electronic configuration, if you are remembering yesterday's lecture, I said you into the core, into the nucleus of the atom, the protons and chargeless neutrons are present. Positive protons and chargeless neutrons are present. And into the shell around the nucleus, the electrons are revolving into the particular shell, right? The first shell has capacity to occupy 2 electrons, second shell 8, third 18 and 32. But we will not wait to complete the number 18. If in the outermost shell, if there are 2 electrons, then also that particular element can be stable. If into the outermost shell 8 electrons are there, then also such element can be stable. So such stability can get either by donating or accepting electrons. In case of metal, I say you, metals are always donating their electrons and being stable. Right, as they are donating their electrons, as they are donating the negativity, means the electrons which are possessing the negative charge on it, they are having the number of protons 4. Right, but in case of non-metals, what happens? They are acquiring electron to complete their outermost shell. Okay, to become stable, to complete its octet, always it is accepting electrons, and so that the number of electrons are more than the number of protons, and because of them, the non-metals have a tendency to lose their, to accept their electron and to be stable, having a extra negative charge. Understood? See here, 9, its electronic configuration is 2-7. Alright, so if we talk about the fluorine atom, then at the nucleus, I said you, what is present into the nucleus? What is the atomic number? 9, right? So 9 positive protons are present into the nucleus, right? Chargeless neutrons are present into the nucleus. Chargeless neutrons do not possess any charge. Neutrons do not possess any charge. It is present into the nucleus of the atom. And all together, it is called as what? Nucleus. All together, it is called as what? Nucleus. Which is the hardest substance. Sorry, it is the hardest substance. Also, we can say, right now we can say, this is the hardest part of the atom. All the mass of the atom is gathered at the nucleus. And this wall is very strong, and because of that, protons cannot come out. As protons cannot come out, protons are never taking part into the chemical reaction. Then who is taking part into the chemical reaction? Who is moving everywhere anyhow? That is electrons. Okay. So into the first shell, how many electrons are there? I said your electronic configuration. This is called as what? Electronic configuration. Electronic configuration means what, students? The distribution of electrons into the shells. Electronic configuration means what? The distribution of electrons into the shells. So how the electrons are arranged? 2, 7. So into the first shell, how many? 2 electrons are present. Means first shell is fulfilled. There is no problem for the first shell because the capacity of the first shell to occupy 2 electrons. Right? So now we will talk about the second shell. Then second shell will have how many electrons? 7 electrons. 4 I have completed. 5, 6 and 7. Right? Means it is highly unstable, student. It's highly unstable. A fluorine is highly unstable now. How can it be stable? How can it be stable? See, 7 electrons are there into the outermost shell. It can be stable by two ways, students. It can be stable by two ways. Right? First way is to donate 7 electrons. But it is not possible, students, because to donate 7 electrons, the fluorine should have a lot of energy, and that much energy fluorine do not have. Right? Fluorine do not have that much energy to donate 7 electrons, and it's not a easy task. It's a very big deal for the fluorine to donate 7 electrons. Right? So this way or this first condition is cancelled. Now this is, it will not work at all. Now there is second way. What is the second way to become stable? Right? The second way is what? To accept 1 electron. Yes, fluorine would say it is easy. I have only 7 electrons. If I will take 1 electron, I will become stable. Happy in my life. Happy go lucky I would be in future. Because I will have 1 electron, I will become stable. My life is settled now. Like that fluorine would say. And fluorine is doing also the same. What fluorine is doing? Fluorine is taking 1 electron. Now from whom it is taking, that matter I shall not disclose now. That is also one secret which we will learn in detail in further classes. This is going to be very interesting, from whom it is going to be taken. Understood? So what it will do? Fluorine will accept 1 electron. Fluorine will accept 1 electron from anyone else. From whom? We will see later. It will accept 1 electron. As it will accept 1 electron, it will become stable. Right? But the number of protons are how many? 9 into the nucleus, which are not coming out, which are not taking part into the chemical reaction. It is into the core, it is into the nucleus. Right? So 9 protons are present. Protons are never changing. Protons are being same. But now what will happen? As it has accepted 1 electron, now it has 10 electrons. How many electrons? It has 10 electrons. And electrons are possesses the charge negative. Right? So plus 9, minus 10. Which charge will be more here? Minus. Right? By how many means it is? By 1 charge it is extra. Na? If it would be plus 9, minus 9 in the previous case, this atom was electrically neutral. The atom was electrically neutral of the fluorine. Do you get me? When it was into the elemental form, that time the protons were 9 and electrons were also 9, and because of that, fluorine atom was electrically neutral. Right? But now situation is different. What is the situation? Electron has gained. Now it has taken 1 electron. It has taken 1 electron, so that the number of electrons are more than the number of protons. As the number of electrons are more, so it has a more negative charge. And because of that, now this fluorine atom will turn out into fluorine ion. It will turn out to be fluorine ion, which is the charged particle now. It was, I used to write before it plus fluorine, because plus 9 proton, plus 9 electron. So it has no charge on it. But when I had accepted 1 electron, now it is minus 1 charge. But 1 we don't write. So now it is turned out to be F minus. Now it is turned out to be F minus. F minus means what? 1 electron is more in it. It has 1 electron extra. It has 1 extra negativity. So its charge will be F minus. Now it is the charged particle. And it has a negative charge on it. It is called as what? Anion. Last time I said you, metals are cation because they have a positive charge on it. And non-metals are anion because they have a negative charge on it. So now it is turned out to be what? Charged particle. It's charged particle now. As well as it is also called as what? Anion. Right? If it will accept two electrons. Now I am not talking about fluorine. If I will take any other element which is non-metal, if it is accepting two electrons, then it will be having minus 2 charge on it. Right? So as we will go in detail, I shall explain you in detail everything what happens from whom it has taken electron. So this is all about what? Non-metal. So last session we have seen what is mean by metal, and in today's session we have seen what is mean by non-metal. I hope the concept of the non-metal is clear for you. Okay, so and if you have any query, please do let me know. I shall solve your queries. There will be no problem for you in future also. And you should know before starting this lesson, materials, metal and non-metals, you must know the concept of the metal and the non-metal. If you know the concept of the metal and non-metal, the further session is going to be very easy for you. So, it's my kind request for all of you students, do watch this video very carefully, okay? And if it is possible, prepare your own notes also, okay? And then too, if you have any problem, it is there, like that student. It's like that some children can not understand. Then you can let me know, I shall again explain you, okay? So, thank you so much.